Okay, so talking about peace amongst order and chaos, it's taken a few goes and things have been glitching. So, wonderful, I'm so glad it's working. So yes, excuse me, I'm just changing things around a bit and some things had to be put in sync. So I'm going to do the 4 minutes to connect to peace whilst there is chaos or order, and also how to really navigate with it. So the first thing is make yourself comfortable, roll your shoulders back, sit however you feel really good, or lie down if you wish. And I'm just going to discuss firstly very briefly so that you can really embrace chaos and order and be peaceful with it, and also navigate what actually suits your style and what is actually healthy for you in that moment. So, first of all, as you close your eyes, I want you to remember a time when you had a lot of order in your life. When it felt like everything was just going according to a predictable pattern. Maybe you were, you know, under a system perhaps like school or at home, or you were just having a lazy holiday and everything felt like it was so peaceful and there was a sense of order to it and things were predictable. So, okay. All right. So, this is all very funny. It's just going to be my funny YouTube. And look, that's what it is. We have to accept what goes on in life and we have to just grow with it. And I'm actually discussing, I've already done one meditation on this today, but it didn't stream and it got lost in the internet, cybernet, whatever. So this one might be a bit longer. So basically there were times when you've had order and you really enjoyed it. Remembering a time when you enjoyed just that order, you had everything sorted. Maybe you were doing meal preps, maybe you were on holiday and everything was just going great. Everything in the hotel worked and that place that you booked worked. And you're really enjoying it and you're relaxing and feel that within you, because really, ultimately it's your response to order or chaos which determines your experience. So feel that relaxation within and that sense of perhaps relaxation you had when you had perceived order. Although there is never real order around us. So in a moment, we're going to go into that as well. So feeling that order, but imagine everything is totally predictable and you're a kind of person that likes a bit of adventure and you like a bit of change and you like a sense of challenge and evolution, and you're just a bit over. Say you're on that same holiday island for 5 years. Same sort of stuff, same island, similar people, la la la, and you're really a bit sick of that kind of seeming order and patterning. So you could end up feeling bored. You could end up feeling, well, I need a bit of a challenge. I need something to spice things up. And the good news is that we always have that around us. So we are constantly surrounded by order and chaos, which appear to us differently depending on the lenses through which we view things and depending on what our preference is actually as well. Because what is order to me could be chaos to you, and what is chaos to you could be perfectly something I'm very comfortable in and feels like an order. So now I want you to think of a time when you felt there was a lot of chaos around you. Maybe you're moving house. Maybe you were getting ready to go on a holiday. Maybe you were meeting a new person and you're sort of trying to figure out how do we catch up, you know, what's happening, or you're doing a new course at university and it feels really chaotic at first. Or as a scientist, for example, when I first started learning certain techniques, they really seemed, wow, there's so much to learn, and it felt like a lot of chaos that I had to create order within. So I knew how to do those experiments. I knew what the solutions were like, the techniques, the timings, the temperatures, all the situations that basically, or the parameters that affect the experiment. So at one point that could feel really exciting, right? You may be falling in love, you're going on a holiday, you're planning a trip, and there's lots of brochures all around you, lots of options. That is exciting. At the same time, if you were constantly in that chaos and nothing was settling in, that will make you feel a little bit edgy, right? Say you are renovating a kitchen, or you're going to a uni, but you don't know where to enroll. You don't know how to catch the lecturers to ask questions, or in your kitchen it takes forever. There's constant chaos. So these things are always around us. Our life is filled with the sense of chaos, depending on how we look at it, and a sense of order. Now, order can be really peaceful and predictable, or, as I said, it can also be boring and unchallenging. It won't take you out to do something new, to be innovative. And at the same time, chaos can be really exhilarating and can be wonderful, but too much of it can have you not restful enough, and perhaps too much running on that adrenaline rush, right? So the idea to have that peace is really by noticing that you're the one observing it through your lenses, and just take a deep breath in. And as you exhale, if you haven't closed your eyes already, just close them and recognize that within you there's a constant mechanism repairing your blood, your bones, your organs. It would seem chaotic depending on the lenses you did, and yet when you look at the bigger picture, there is amazing order that creates your body biomechanism, which is linked with your mind and your lenses. And even though you can't predict what you're going to do tomorrow, it feels like you can predict it. So the way to be at peace with chaos in order is actually to sit back and let it be as it is. Notice it. Wow, this is chaotic, or wow, this is really ordered and really locked in, or really too restrictive within the order even. And then just looking at it and going, wow, so how does that make me feel? What do I actually want? Do I enjoy this? And how did I manifest it around me? And do I want to change something? Do I want to change the way I look at it? Or do I want to change the way my life is directed? And that's, again, the beauty of chaos in order. And finding peace within it is also an option. You might be excited, you might be angry, you might be agitated. The idea that I'm talking about peace is because most people tend to look for peace. We need a bit of a break from too much order, from too much chaos, from confusion, from certainty, which is never really certain because everything is always changing. So let yourself be the observer and then reflect on how much order and chaos is right for you. What actually serves your personality style, but also this moment, because in sometimes in our lives we love dynamic chaos, we want to be creative, we want to meet new people, we want to have things, this is integrate so that something new can be born. So sometimes people have so much chaos around them that they also crash because it's just too much. And then that is again the foundation for something new, an assessment and a re-evaluation, right? Sometimes people keep so much order and hold everything so tight that it has to break. It cannot be held because nothing in nature stays the same. So if you hold on to something, you literally suffocate it. And then again, that has to crack open, and that will create a sense of, wow, unknown, what's going on, I've lost control. But the truth is, you've never really had control. So realizing that and really sitting in that and just letting yourself be observant and noticing if something is triggering you, right? Like this thing today took an hour to sort, and I'm not even 100% sure if it's going to go through, but I could have gone crazy or whatever it is. I could have done laughing, which I've done. I could have thought, I give up. Again, according to my day, I had a really nice day. I went to the hairdresser. I had a relaxing day. But who knows, if I was really hungry and I did 10 other things, I might have just thought, I'll try again tomorrow. And that's perfect also for you, choosing your moments, how to respond to order and creating something new, using the foundation to create something new, or how you respond to chaos by running with it, enjoying it, appreciating it, or resisting it and getting angry or frustrated with it. Can you see how all of this has its own perfection? It does, and everything has its fruition and its outcome that you can then see as a gift or even as a learning or a teaching for your life and for yourself. So take a deep breath in and realize you are the master of your life ultimately, and you can choose to meet each dynamic, each situation with your own chosen way, your own capacity to be compassionate, joyful, patient, erratic, whatever that is. It's a beautiful option in life to be able to choose and to be able to notice, okay, things go wrong all the time, but some of us just go, okay, this didn't quite flow, I can do something. Or other people just really get stuck in it and get upset and then later realize they could have just flowed with it. Or being at home, perhaps not going to work, was actually the perfect thing. They needed to get upset that the car didn't start. They didn't think that they might want to take a taxi. They stayed at home and something beautiful happened. Maybe they wrote a poem. Maybe they meditated. Maybe they got that sleep so the body can heal itself. So the immune system is strong again. So that next time, that you would have normally got a cold or a flu, it wouldn't have happened because you stayed at home. And the universe has a funny way of letting those things unfold, which is why you could even look at it that there's a bigger picture always. And that's why amongst the chaos, there is the order, and amongst the order, there is the chaos. And it's a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful contemplation. So I hope that helped. I hope you enjoyed it, just being with that. And if you've got any questions, comments, or sharing, let me know. And again, this links back to some of my other YouTubes, which I've done, which are very much about being in the moment, being the observer. I talk about those sorts of things, and I teach little mini meditations on that, and they can really help you just to observe, wow, this is a moment of order. This is a moment of chaos. And look how things can change. And what does that mean for me? What can I do? So sending lots of positive vibes, and know that constant positive vibes also are not necessary. We need the polarity in the three-dimensional reality to know what we really want. And that's where the ascension is happening right now, where we're moving out of some of that polarity into the fourth and fifth dimension, where things change a lot, where things are more subtle and things are less polar. And that means you become more of the observer, and there's less judgment about how things should be. And that resistance to these things, there's more flow in that aspect. So be proud of yourself for having survived this long amongst order and chaos, and perhaps resisting it and wishing things were different. And just notice that you can take a deep breath in, and as you exhale, just melt into this moment and just let it be as it is. It's a wonderful place to be. So, thank you for your patience as well, and see you next time. Okay.
There.